The general manager of ECHO, Steve Etienne, says that in the Caribbean, there is a large number of abusers of copyrights. The electronic media, Steve Etienne says, are largely unlicensed outside of St. Lucia. Mr. Etienne says ECHO has gone through the process of discussion in a bid to settle these cases amicably, but to no avail.
Our next stage is to file an action. The lead up to filing an action is, of course, the gathering of evidence, gathering of documentation from the Americas, from the UK, whose content was used, getting power of attorneys, for example, that we have from ASCAP and BMI, allowing us to act on their behalf as if the property belonged to us.
Mr. Etienne says that the abusers know who they are and may very well follow its best compliance users. Mr. Etienne says that ECHO's sister copyright organizations in the Caribbean have already been taking action against abusers. Several users are before the courts, including two in St. Lucia.
After we have finally instructed our cadre of lawyers that we have, not just in St. Lucia, but across the Eastern Caribbean, when we finalize our slate, once we've had that conversation with our legal representative, our attorneys, then we will be publishing a slate as strong and as powerful as the one published by the Jamaican Society.
The general manager of ECHO says that the organization has not finalized its list. However, he expects that it will be done within the next 2 weeks. Mr. Etienne says that cable companies, radio stations, and hotels are among some of the abusers whose names will be published. For the DBS News World, I am Cecil Actill.